Assalamualaikum, go to the store and select a mechanical design. Inside the mechanical design, we need to select a power design. Then select a plane correspondingly where you want to sketch and go for sketch a workbench. Then you have to draw a circle with the origin point. Then you have to specify the dimensional constraints for the circle based upon your requirement. After that, you need to exit the workbench, then apply the pad definition for a circle. You can specify the first limit and second limit based upon your requirement. After specifying the first limit, just click more for second limit. Then you have to specify the length. After that, we need to make a project element at end face of the cylindrical bar. So select a mid plane. Then go to the sketcher workbench. We need to use a project element command, so select a project element command and select the edge of the cylindrical bar. Exit the workbench. Now we are creating a project element at end face. Then we are going to use generative shape design. You can also use a wireframe or surface design in a mechanical design, or otherwise you can use a shape design and click the generative shape design. Inside them, just you are go for insert. Inside the insert, we have to select a wireframe. Then we have to select a helix in a wireframe. After selecting a helix in a wireframe, we have to specify the start point. The start point is nothing but the start point is specified in a project element. Then we have to select the axis based upon your requirement. Just right click on the axis, you have to specify axis based upon your requirement. Then you need to change the pitch value and the height value for the helix curve. You can change the reverse direction based upon your requirement. While we are making knurling, just try to give the maximum value for pitch and height of the spring. You need to specify the height at a maximum value. Just try to maximize your pitch and height at the end where you need to create a required curve. Just hide the unwanted planes. Then we need to edit a helix curve. Just double click on the helix curve and then you have to specify the mode value for pitch and revolution. After specifying the pitch value for maximum, just we are going to use a mirror or symmetry. You can also select a midplane here. So just show the midplane vertically. Select a plane which we are using vertically here. Then we are going for use a mirror or symmetry. You can select a symmetry in your toolbox. Or otherwise, you can go for insert. Inside the insert, we need to select a operations. So select your operations at the below. Inside the operation, we need to select a symmetry option. Just click a symmetry. Then you have to specify the element. Element is nothing but element is a helix and curve. Then select a midplane for the references. Then click OK. Now our curve is completely mirrored. Just hide the unwanted planes. Then we need to go for mechanical design and pod design. Now we are using a reference element plane. Just change the plane type as a normal to curve. Then select a corresponding curve and end point of the curve. For creating a profile, just click OK. Then we need to make another plane for another curve. Repeat the procedure. Select a curve and endpoint for the plane definition with a normal to curve. Then select a plane one by one and draw a profile corresponding to the curve. Now you have to just select a circle and draw a profile. Then you have to use here dimensional constraints. After specifying the diameter, you need to apply the Exeter workbench. Then click another plane and draw a profile for another curve. Here we need to draw a circle with normal to our curve. After drawing a profile, just you have to specify the dimensional constraints. Then you need to specify the geometrical constraints if you are need. Just exit the workbench. Hide the unwanted planes here. Just click the planes one by one and hide the planes which you not necessary. After that, we need to use a slot command. So select a slot option in a sketch based feature. Just click slot. Here we have to specify the profile as a circle and then select our curve as a helix curve. Just click OK. Now the slot is created. You need to transformation features here. So go for insert. Inside the insert, we need to specify the transformation features. Just we need to select a circular pattern. Inside the circular pattern, we need to select a crown definition. Select a parameter as a crown definition or complete crown. Then you need to specify the number of instances which we want to produce here. Inside the reference element, just click the cylindrical face of your ball. Then you need to select the objects to be pattern. It's a slot. Just drag the specification tree. Inside the specification tree, you need to select a slot which you want to pattern here. Then click OK. After that, you need to make a slot for another curve. So you just select again another slot. Here you have to specify the profile and center curve based upon your requirement. Now the slot is created here. Just click OK. Repeat the procedure. You have go for transformation features. Just go to insert and select a transformation feature and select a circular pattern. Inside the circular pattern, we need to specify the parameter as a complete crown. Then you need to specify the number of instances as 13 and specify the reference element and select your objects to be pattern as a slot 2. Select in a design tree or a specification tree, just click OK. Now the knurling is generating here. Now the knurling is successfully created. Just hide the unwanted sketches and planes for a better visualization. At last, you can specify the material for the aesthetic look. Just click the apply material and select a material type as a metal or color. I select here metal. Then you can select a metal based upon your requirement. Drag and place it in your component. Just click apply material. Now the material is applied here successfully. To get the regular updates of my video, please subscribe in my channel. Don't forget to like and share. Inshallah, we will meet in next video. Thanks for watching. I hope you are subscribed. I'm not